viewers, welcome to the Home Economics Show once again. Today we have a great personality with us. We have the National GRASAC President, who is also a home economics. She's going to interact with us and tell us her journey through the course and how home economics is influencing her activities as the National GRASAC President. Please welcome to the Home Economics Show.
Thank you.
Our viewers would like to know your name.
My name is Hartwell Selassie Tamaklo.
So she's Hartwell Selassie Tamaklo, the GRASAC President,
National President.
Please, it's national. If I made a mofa chairman, it's national. So please tell us, as a home economist, what has your journey been? What was your passion?
Yeah, thank you so much. As a home economist, the course itself is humanitarian oriented, and it teaches us a lot with how to deal with people, how to care for people. It also helps us to understand people in terms of their feeling, because it's about the home, and as home managers, you are dealing with the people in the home. So the course has actually broadened my understanding about the perception of people in terms of whatever they do, how they want you to treat them, how they want you to relate with them. So the home economics course is not just about cooking and clothing, but it's cut across personal human relations as well.
Wow. So you see, it's not just about cooking and clothing, as you see always. It teaches you how to, and I like the word she used, how to influence your relationship with people. So please, in regards to that, how has this impacted being the, I heard, Ben whispered to me that you used to be the GRASAC President for UUW, and now you are the National GRASAC President. So how has this influenced your journey, if any?
Yeah, thank you so much. Before becoming the GRASAC President UEW, I was SRC Secretary. And from SRC Secretary to GRASAC President UEW, and now the National GRASAC President. I would say that mostly our constituents are looking at someone who can listen to them, someone who would be there for them in times of their needs. And the fact that you possess those characteristics, it puts you above others. It creates more opportunity for you whenever you want to go into the political field. So with my background as home economist and knowing all those things, it has really influenced my journey in the political arena.
Wow. So you see, home economics, we did create the standard. So please, do you have any goodwill messages for people that are still confused? You know, there are people that really want to study home economics, but they're not getting the vibe. You know, home economics is for people who are not intelligent or knowledgeable, but that is not the case. So do you have anything, any advice for people out there?
In fact, you have already said it, that is not the case. You see, for you to be able to relate with people well, for you to take care of people's stomach and understand people's behavior as well as what they eat, what they do, and even entrepreneurship involved, customer relationship and all those things, you realize that the course is much involving. It has business in it, it has science, it has mathematics, it has chemistry, there is physics. So you ask yourself, those doing pure science and someone doing home economics, are they not the same? So I tell my students that if you are doing home economics and you think it's because you are dumb, that's why you are doing home economics, then go back home. Because home economics is not for dumb people. It is for the clever. Because you must be clever to understand, to put all these courses together. Someone is doing one course. Someone is doing physics. Someone is doing chemistry. It's one. But you are blending a lot. So you must be very clever and smart for you to be able to blend all this. So home economics is not for the dumb.
Not at all.
Not at all.
In fact, somebody would say it's a hard course, but it's a fun course. You need to be creative. You need to think.
Yes. If you are not creative, you don't think ahead of time, you realize that you will be found wanting in the course. I would say that most of the times, if we have to even organize programs, because of my entrepreneurship ability and then the knowledge and organization, I can sit at one place on paper, I will do everything, and it's just within a twinkle of an eye, I will organize a whole program, and you think it is a program that was organized over the about weeks. So if you are not smart, please don't try to come and do home economics
at all. So thank you so much. She has thrown the ball back to you. Be smart, be creative, be ready to think, then you can pursue the home economics dream. And like we have been saying, home economics just doesn't train you for books. At the end of the course, you become entrepreneurial. So if you are hungry, then it is you. You now, you are being lazy. So
home it's your laziness that is keeping you hungry.
Exactly. So members and viewers, we've been talking to Madam Hartwell, the National GRASAC president, and also a home economics on the home economics show. Madam, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you too.
And next week, we'll come your way again with the show. So bye-bye for us.